Hey, it's Jason O'Phil, your gay geeker, and I'm coming at you today with my review for Hot Toys. Quicksilver 1/6 scale figure from Marvel's
Avengers Age of Ultron.
Now, I do know sometimes Hot Toys can be hit or misses. Like, for example, I love the Star-Lord action figure, but I don't think the likeness is very close to Chris Pratt. But this likeness looks exactly like Aaron Taylor Johnson. I don't even know where to begin. I love the detail of the wisps of hair. I'm one of those people that prefers sculpted hair to real hair. It looks good on the girl action figures, but on the boys, I just think the sculpted hair is sublime. Look at the detail of the scruff. I mean, this paint job is pristine. The eyes, the scruff, even the little flourishes of his freckles on his face. I mean, Hot Toys, once again, they know how to paint a figure. You can't really do much moving of the head. You can't really go back. You can't really go forward. For me, that's okay. I'm okay with the face not being fully mobile. I do know some of the Hot Toys come that way. I know Star-Lord is very mobile. I know that Captain America is fairly mobile. And I know that Hawkeye is fairly mobile. He's running. He doesn't need to be looking around. Now, unfortunately, this figure doesn't come with a lot of accessories. Actually, he comes with none. He comes with an assortment of hands. I chose the hands that you saw earlier because I wanted him to look like he was running midair. His costume is not removable. So if you get this action figure and you think, I want to take his shirt off because maybe I don't like the muscle tone of the body and I can get a better body from a doll shop. No, no, no. You cannot take this shirt off. You can take the pants off, though. I have to give props where props are due also on the details of the sneakers. Like, look at that. I mean, somewhere Adidas is going, yes, honey, yes, we make good shoes. Now, look. Is this an important figure to have? That's going to be a personal question for you. For me, I really like to complete the Avengers Age of Ultron lineup as much as possible. I'm kind of sick of the multiple Iron Mans. I'm sorry, I'm just going to say that. And even though I know he is only in this one movie, as of now, we don't know what could happen in Infinity Wars. I think it complements the Age of Ultron line really well. And I think it's another slam dunk for Hot Toys, personally. They just keep on getting better and better. I worry about what will happen the next 5 years of how incredibly good these toys will be. I mean, mine will look like the Kenner Star Wars toys from the 70s, and then the future ones will look like the Kenner toys from now. Actually, those really aren't an upgrade. The one from the 70s are much better. But you know what? I digress. I'm a completionist, so I wanted him and I wanted his sister, and I feel like he was a good investment. But once again, that's going to be up to you if you want to spend the $220. Choose wisely. Well, I'm going to give this an 8.5 out of 10 for a toy review. So, once again, if you want it, buy it. My name's Jason O'Phil. I'm your gay geeker, and I hope you guys have an amazing day. Do you think if I wish upon a star, I can make him a real boy?